So I'm a new African Canadian. I came to Canada 4 years ago, and when I first came, it was very important for me to know what the issues were for African Canadians. I lived between Britain and the US, and in Britain and the US, you rarely hear about African Canadians, and I didn't even know that the country that I originate from, Sierra Leone, had strong links with Canada in Nova Scotia. And so it was really important for me to know what the issues were as a black woman coming to Canada. And I knew I didn't have time to read novels, so I thought, okay, let me pick up some poetry books by African Canadians. And then I was trying to find a national anthology, and I couldn't find anything. And later on, I actually became aware of Harold Head's book, Canada in Us Now, but there was very little that I could find in terms of a national anthology. And so I just thought, well, yeah, we should have a, there should be an anthology recognizing all these voices. And what I should say, living in Edmonton, I was very much very active within the slam community. I was the coach for the Edmonton slam team, and so I became very familiar with some of the issues because three of the people in that slam team were black initially. And actually, that team actually went on to win the Canadian National Slam Competition.
When Valerie had asked me if I'd be interested in a project that would be a new national anthology for African Canadian poets, I said yes. I think for myself, my work has an aspect of identity, an aspect of knowledge of self, black history. And so I thought it was also appropriate that we kind of work on an anthology because it was the right time. In terms of timing, there's a spoken word generation that was at these poetry slams. My first experience stepping up to the spoken word stage was at Vancouver Poetry Slam. And I was on the team in 2007 and 2008, and we got to travel and kind of meet this community and network of poets who are really the griots, the contemporary griots in our society. So my first year went out to Halifax in Nova Scotia, and it was kind of incredible because you have the history of that place and you had all of these poets that kind of congregated there that would later become, you know, either people who I looked up to or would work with or were in the anthology. And so that really kind of stimulated me and let me know I was on the right path. So when Valerie kind of approached me with this, with her idea and why she wanted to do the anthology, I think it made sense in terms of it was the next step on the path. So whether it's slam poetry or dub poetry or spoken word in the sense of performance, that's also connected to the print poetry that we might see from some of the established generation poets. And so to be able to kind of connect those dots and bring them together into the same book is pretty incredible.
I mean, also for me, well, firstly, just wanting to say how important it was for us to have consultants on the project as well. And so it was really fantastic when George Eliot Clark agreed to be our consultant and advisor on the book and brought on Karina Vernon. And then also some of our advisors we've had, like Alice Major, who's given a lot to our project. The black voice has been seen to be the protest voice, and that the black voice often hasn't been recognized as a page poet voice or a print poet voice, and that actually, as black poets, we're not as good as the white-haired poet. And for me, I mean, I know that actually that isn't true, and also that, you know, as black poets, we do work in different genres, like dub. You know, as a young person, I grew up listening to dub. My poetry was going to blues and shabins and listening to people toasting over music. That's where I became a writer, and that was so important for me, and it's like, why isn't that recognized? And of course we have the people like Linton Kwesi John, who has made, has put dub poetry on the map. But just, you know, as poets, we're spoken word poets, and often
We have to be spoken word poets because people won't publish us. You know, if we're going to get published, then we have to self-publish ourselves. And the only way for us to promote our work is to be spoken word poets, because then we don't have to ask somebody to publish us. But actually, there's some very good spoken word poetry out there. There's some very good slam poetry out there. So it was very important for us to recognize those different genres within in the black tradition and actually explore that within in the anthology.
Yeah, a lot of what we do is continuing the oral tradition, so it might be natural that we do spoken word and performance poetry. But at the same time, like Valerie mentioned, there's some brilliant writers in Canada that are poets of African descent. And for me, I was born in Edmonton, Alberta. My family is Jamaican, so I grew up with a lot of influences that came from reggae music. But the culture that I really attached myself to was hip-hop culture. In hip-hop, you have lyricists and you have rappers that are basically continuing the same tradition of toasting and the sound clash culture that came up from Jamaica and became dubbing. And so, you know, we have a motto in Jamaica, out of many, one people. So, you know, I think regardless of age and even region, in Canada, you know, we can kind of say, you know, out of many, one poem. You know, there are links that we are definitely finding in this anthology, and I think once it's released in February 2013, you need to have that in your collection, in your library, in your hand. You're going to want to read that, you're going to want to know these poets, and yeah, it's been a pleasure to go through this whole process.